Very good morning to all of you. Today I am going to take about the topic mutual fund in securities market. Mutual fund is an investment in capital market. Mutual fund is common. Mutual fund always pulls money from all investors, and this money is invested in different type of securities market in accordance to the stated objective. Mutual fund is there are many types of funds available in mutual fund. Equity fund, bond fund, and balanced fund. Equity fund is mainly invested in shares, preference shares, warrants, etc. Bond fund is mainly invested in debentures, bonds, government securities, and money market securities. And balanced fund. This fund is mainly invested in both equity market as well as in bond market. 50% of the fund is invested in equity and 50% of the fund is invested in the bond market. So it is called as balanced fund. Mutual fund shareholders are units, or is otherwise called as unit shareholders, because they are getting shares in the form of units. But in stock market, they are getting their shares in the form of ordinary shares. Next. This is the sum of the myths about the mutual fund. Mutual fund is only invest in shares. Mutual funds are prone to very high risk and traded in a yearly basis. Mutual fund is a very high, medium risk investment and also high risk investment, because when you are investing in stock market, we have to face many high risks. Then only we have getting more returns. Mutual funds are very new to the financial market, and mutual funds are not reliable and people rarely invest in them. Most of the people are not aware of the mutual funds, because since in 1963, first mutual fund, UTI mutual fund, is the first mutual fund which is started in India. It is act as a monopoly mutual fund. After 2000, many mutual funds are coming to the market. Mutual funds, equity instruments like shares are only a part of securities which is held by mutual fund. Mutual funds are invested in debt securities, which are relatively much safer. When you are investing in debt market, it is a bond market. It is giving only a low return, but it is giving more safety. So the investment in debt securities is very important. Next, mutual funds are there in India since 1964. I already mentioned you that UTI is the first mutual fund which is started in the year 1964. Mutual funds market are available in USA, and it is that for the last 60 years it is available. Mutual funds are the best solutions for the people who want to manage risk and get good returns. Next. This next fact of mutual fund is US is very much a part of market and is not immune to the vagaries, and crisis has risen due to mismanagement of the fund. When you are doing some mismanagement in the fund, automatically the investor will face problems of getting low, very low returns. This is the cyclic process of the mutual fund. First one is the investors. Investor means the mutual fund company can pool or mobilize the money from all the investors who are interested in investing in capital market or mutual funds. After pooling the money from the investors, the fund manager's responsibility is he has to collect the amount from the investor and invest in many portfolio. He has to frame the portfolio. Whether it may be a he has to plan whether it may be a IT sector or whether it may be a pharma sector or software sector, he has to plan the portfolio. According to the portfolio, the investment will be held. Then suppose the fund manager want to invest the whole amount in securities market, means he invest the amount in securities market in different schemes. There are several types of schemes available in the mutual fund. One is growth fund, income fund, balanced fund, and tax saving scheme. There are the many types of schemes are available. According to the portfolio which is designed by the fund manager, the amount is invested in the particular securities. After the returns will be happened based on the behavior of the market. When the market is booming, means automatically the net asset value of the company is also increasing. So the particular particular fund is may also, the net asset value will be increasing. If there is no problem when you are investing in the mutual fund, if you invest the money in the mutual fund, means it has to face whenever the net asset value is increases means you have get the minimum number of returns. When the market is also decreasing means we have get the more number of units. Both way you are the investor is getting benefited. After securities, the returns will be going back to the investors. This is the main process involved in the mutual fund. This is the history of the mutual fund. History of the mutual funds can be discussed in two ways. One is emergence through the public players, another one is the emergence through the private players. There are four phases available in the mutual fund. First phase, 1964 to 1987. In 1963, UTI, United Trust of India, was set up by the government under the UTI Act and given a monopoly. This first equity fund was launched in the year 1986, the first UTI mutual fund was launched. Next phase 2 is 1987 to 1993. This is not UTI market. Other than UTI, the other public sector and private sector are involved in this. Public sector mutual funds like SBI mutual funds, CAN Bank, Canara Bank mutual funds, LIC mutual funds, Indian Bank mutual funds, GIC mutual funds, Punjab National Bank mutual funds are some of the public sector mutual funds. The phase 3 is 1993 to 1996. Here, the introduction of the private sector funds as well as open-ended scheme. Open-ended scheme is nothing but whenever the investors want to enter into the mutual fund and want to exit into the mutual fund, there is no entry load and exit load for open-ended scheme. But for closed-ended scheme, there is some exit load is there. This is the phase 3. Next phase 4, this is in the year 1996. Investors friendly regulated measures taken by SEBI to protect the investors and to enhance the investors' returns through the tax benefits. Mainly for the tax benefits, the phase 4 is available. The SEBI is taking more care of the returns of the investors. Next we are going to see the types of mutual funds. We can segregate the mutual funds by structure. Segregating the mutual fund by structure, there are three types. One is open-ended funds, closed-ended funds, and also the interval funds. Open-ended funds, I already mentioned you that open-ended funds means the investor want to invest in the mutual funds, he can enter at any time and also he can exit at any time. There is no closing maturity period for this open-ended scheme. But also for the closed-ended scheme, the investor want to enter into this scheme means he can invest the money, but when he want to exit from the mutual funds means there is some maturity period is available for the closed-ended scheme. So he has to pay some commission, then only exit load, then only he can close the redeem his mutual funds. That is closed-ended funds. Next is interval funds. Interval funds means he want to invest up to 6 months or 1 year. There is some time period is maintaining for these interval schemes. Next, mutual fund is classified based upon the investment objectives. One is growth funds, income funds, balanced funds, money market funds, load funds, and no load funds. Growth funds means the market when the net asset value is growing means automatically your investment value is also growing. That is the growth fund. Next one is income fund. Income fund means that there are some schemes available in the schemes available based on the income. So it is called as income funds. Next one is balanced fund. Balanced fund means the portfolio manager has to decide the investment based upon the balanced scheme. He has to plan up to 50% in equity and 50% in bond market. So it is called as balanced fund. Next one is money market fund. In the money market fund, the another way of capital financial market is money market. There are two types of market in the financial systems. One is capital market, another one is money market. In the money market, there are many types available. One is called money market, and certificate of deposit, treasury bills, promissory notes are available in the money market. So the fund managers are planning to invest in the money market because the security is more we are investing in the money market. Next one is load fund. Load fund means there is some exit load is available for this scheme. No load, no, there is no exit load is available. Next last thing, so the investment is based on the tax. Also it is called as tax saving schemes. sometimes the investors investing their money in the mutual fund to get some more tax benefit. Suppose the investor is gaining more income, means he want to plan, he has to pay more taxes. For reducing for the need of exemption of the tax, he is planned for investing in the tax saving scheme. Some of the advantages of the mutual fund, there are many advantages when you are investing in the mutual fund. One is portfolio diversification, professional management, reduction or diversification of risk, reduction of transaction cost, and wide choice to suit risk return profile. Portfolio diversification means what you mean by diversification? Instead of investing in one single securities, we are planning to invest in different type of securities or different type of sectors. It's called as diversification. Portfolio diversification means it is enables him to hold a diversified investment portfolio even with a small amount of investments like 2000. Suppose the investor is having 2000 rupees, means the investor has to give the 2000 rupees to the fund manager. The fund manager is planning this 2000 rupees. He has to invest 1000 rupees to the debt market and 1000 rupees to the equity market. That is the portfolio diversification. Next one is professional management. This is the investment management skills along with the need of research, available investment options ensure a better returns as compared to what an investor can manage on his own. Professional management means the investor has to plan, make note of what he invests, what he invests, what returns he is earning after 1 month. That is the professional management. What is the investment? He is invested in the equity market or he is invested in the capital market. That's why it is a mutual fund investment is one of the professional management scheme. Next one is reduction or diversification of risk. There are some losses which are happened when you are investing in equity market. When you are investing in mutual fund, means the loss can be reduced because it is a diversified portfolio. So the investment loss is very less in the mutual fund. Next one is reduction of transaction cost. Investor has the benefit of economies of scale and funds pay lesser cost because large balance and it is deposited onto the investor. In the stock market, there are many number of buyers and many number of sellers is there. So we can't know which price the investor is quoting, which price the investor is buying and selling. So there are many number of risk which is available in the cash market. But in mutual funds, that we no need to worry about this investments. So this is the reduction. There is no reduction. There is a reduction of transaction cost in the mutual fund. And why it was to choose risk return profile. Investors can choose the fund based on the risk tolerance and expected returns. Investor can always think about the future return. Then only he can get more returns and he can reduce his own risk. Next one is liquidity. Liquidity is the redemption of your schemes. Mutual fund is the redemption of schemes is liquidity. Whenever the investor invested in some securities market, means he want to, for some emergency purpose, he wants some money. So he want to redeem that money from the security market. If you are investing in the stock market, means it is very difficult for him to get money at present time. But you are investing in the mutual funds, it means for the next 1 hour only he can get the amount. For the same day he can get the amount. That is the liquidity. Next one is convenience and flexibility. Investors can easily transfer their holdings from one scheme to another. There are some facilities which is available in the mutual funds. If the investors are investing in the growth fund, means he want to invest into income fund, means easily the amount available funds are easily transferred from the growth fund to the income fund or growth fund to the tax saving schemes. There are some facilities which is available in the mutual funds, but in the security market there is no such facilities. Next one is transparency. The fund gives regular information to the investors on the value of the investments. In addition to the disclosure of the portfolio, it is held by the scheme. Actually, the transparency means for every 6 months the investor is getting the holding statement. In the holding statement, it is clearly mentioned in which scheme he is invested, how many quantity he is invested, how many units are available up to now, and what is the present value of his investment. That whole details are available. So it is very transparent to the investors. Next. some disadvantages when you are investing in the mutual fund. First one is no control over the cost and no tailor-made portfolio on managing portfolio of funds. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss about this remaining chapter topic. Thank you, Anurag.